The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 19th of November, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
He began this verse yesterday. This is the criterion of understanding spiritual life. People generally do not understand that there is another element beyond this body. Generally, people, they are under the impression that I am this body. I am Indian. Why I am Indian? Because this body is born in India, therefore I am Indian. I am American. Why? That because body is born in America, therefore I am American. Similarly, this Dehatma Buddhi, bodily concept of life is going on all over the world. This is ignorance, ajnana. This is called ajnana. Jnana and ajnana. Jnana means one who knows that he is not this body, he is spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. So, when one is free from the bodily concept of life, he is called jnani, otherwise ajnani. They are so much proud of jnana. In our India, there are so-called Mayavadis. They think of themselves as jnani sampradaya. What is that jnani? I am Hindu. I am Indian. I am sannyasi. This is their jnana. But actually it is ajnana. If you think yourself that you are Indian, if you think yourself as Hindu, if you think yourself as Brahmin, if you think yourself as a Shudra, then you are ajnani. You are not jnani. Because you are giving your identification on the ground of your body, then you are ajnani. Jnani means pandit. Pandita samadarshina vidya vinaye sampanne brahmani gavi hastine sunice cha sapake cha pandita samadarshina. Actually, who is jnani, who is pandit, he will not see, here is an Indian, here is an American, here is an Hindu, here is a Muslim, or here is a cat, here is a dog. No. Because he will see not the outward bodily identification. Just like while I am talking with you, because your dress is white and because my dress is saffron color, it does not mean that we are different. Simply on the ground of dress, if we think we are different, then that is ajnana. Nobody does so. When a gentleman talks with another gentleman, none of them consider that I am this dress. Similarly, if I consider about my identification on the ground of this dress, then am I not ajnani? Yes, I am ajnani. I do not know my identification. Therefore, Shastra says, jasyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke. Anyone who is identifying himself with this body, which is made of tridhatu. Tridhatu means kapha, pitta, vayu, according to Ayurvedic system. This body is a combination of kapha, pitta, vayu, mucus, bile, and air. So, Shastra says, jasyatma buddhi kunape tridhatuke. If anyone identifies himself with this bag of kapha, pitta, vayu, a bunch of bones and flesh and blood and stool, sadhik kalatradishu, and his own kinsmen, his wife and children, sadhik kalatradishu, bhoma ijjadhi, and worshipable is the land, bhoma, jati thabuddhi salile, one who goes to the place of pilgrimage and takes the water as all in all, jatitha buddhi salile, na parhiji janesu abhigyesu, but does not go to the actual learned and saintly person, saiva gokhara. Such person is no better than cow and ass. This is the injunction of the Shastra, that our identification with the body is animal life. The animal, a dog, it knows that he is body. A cat knows that he is body. A tiger knows that he is body. A human being also, if he knows like that he is body, then how he is advanced? He is no better than the cats and dogs. Jasyatma buddhi kunapeti dhatuke sadhik kalatra disubhoma ijjadhi. The whole world is going on this misimpression, misidentification with the body. Therefore, there is fight between one nation to another, one man to another, and so on. So, jnani means one must be above this bodily concept of life. He is jnani. Therefore, to become jnani, the first instruction as Krishna is giving to Arjuna, he is pointing out that you are not this body, my dear Arjuna. You are declining to fight because you are bodily infected. You are thinking that your bodily blood relation with the other party, namely your brothers, nephews and others, that is wrong conception. You are not this body. Because Arjuna surrendered to Krishna, Sishyasteham Sadhimam Prapannam, when he was puzzled in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he thought it wise to accept Krishna not as his friend, but at the same time he accepted him as his spiritual master. Shishyasteham Sadhimam Prapannam. And the duty of the disciple is to fully surrender unto the spiritual master. Unless you can surrender, do not accept anyone as spiritual master. If you want the spiritual master to abide by your order, then that acceptance of spiritual master is a farce. It is not acceptance. Acceptance of spiritual master means that one should surrender unto the spiritual master. Tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. If you want to learn that transcendental science, tadviddhi, you try to understand how pranipatena prakishtarupena nipat, fully surrendering, falling flat, sir, I surrender unto you. Pranipatena, pariprasnena, and then inquire question. according to our Vedic principle, nobody has got the right to question anyone unless that person is accepted as spiritual master. Otherwise it is waste of time. If you want to question somebody, you must accept his answer. You cannot argue. That is acceptance of authority. Just like in Vedas, whatever injunctions are there, we accept it without any argument. That is Vedic instruction. People sometimes say, is it Vedic instruction that I have to accept it without argument? Actually, that is Vedic instruction. Just like, for example, the Veda says cow dung is pure. Now, actually you are accepting, those who are following the Vedic principles, they accept cow dung as pure. Actually it is pure. But if we argue, how is that animal stool is impure, even human stool is impure, how cow dung, which is stool of another animal, is pure? It is contrary. But actually, we accept. Actually, we accept. Similarly, corn cell is nothing but bone of an animal. According to our Vedic version, if you touch the bone of an animal, you become immediately impure, you have to take bath. But this bone of animal, corn cell, is taken to the deity room. It is so pure. So, from our human consciousness, we find contradiction in the Vedic instruction. That is, the Vedas, in one place, it says that the bone of an animal is impure, in another place says the bone of a particular animal is pure. The Veda says the stool of an animal is impure, but in another place it says that the stool of the cow animal is pure. So apparently we find contradiction. But still, because we accept the authority of the Vedas, therefore we accept the statement also, we accept the bone of the corn cell, and we accept the stool of cow as pure. That is acceptance of authority. You cannot argue, even though it appears it is contradictory. You cannot argue. Similarly, acceptance of spiritual master means representative of God. Of course, he must be representative of God. If unfortunately I accept a bogus man as representative, that is my misfortune. But actually, acceptance of spiritual master means he is a bona fide representative of God. Evam parampara praptam imam rajasayo vidu. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, you will find that parampara system, disciplic succession, acharyavan purusha veda, just like we accept our philosophy, Vaishnava philosophy, or any Indian philosophy, they accept this parampara, guru parampara, they accept it. Sampradaya, just like we have got sampradaya, Ramanuja sampradaya, Madhva sampradaya. So we have to accept the sampradaya, disciplic succession, to receive real knowledge. So that sampradaya begins from Krishna. Krishna is the original spiritual master of Lord Brahma, of Lord Shiva, Narada, so many other authorities. There are 12 authorities. Sambhu Narado Sambhu. Sambhu means Lord Brahma, Narada, and Sambhu, Lord Shiva, Kumara, Kapila, Mano, They are all authorities. So that is the indication of the Shastra, that if you want to understand the transcendental science, the science of God, then tad-vijñānārtham sa guru-meva abhigacchet, that is the injunction of the Vedas. That if you really interested to learn the transcendental science, you must approach abhigacchet. This is vidhiling. Vidhiling, this form of verb is used in Sanskrit grammar where it is meant you must. You cannot say I may accept or may not accept. That will not do. You must accept. Tad vijñānārtham sa guru meva vigacchet samipāni sūtriyam brahmanistam. These are the injunctions of the Veda. So, Arjuna accepted Krishna as spiritual master. In the beginning, he was talking like friend. Friend to friend talking, sometimes it comes to nil, no conclusion, simply waste of time. It is called bitanda. That sort of argument has no value because it will never come into conclusion. But when he talk with authority, the spiritual master, the presence of Krishna, then we cannot argue. We have to accept. Guru Vakya, you cannot deny. It may not be agreeable to you in the beginning, but you cannot deny it. That is the system of Vedic system. Here, Arjuna has accepted Krishna as the spiritual master. Shishyate aham, I become your disciple. Because we are talking till now as friends, but this will not decide the case. My case is very serious. My duty is to fight, but I do not like to fight. Some affection, some family relationship is deterring me to fight, making me coward. So therefore, it is a very complex position, and I find that you can make a solution of this complex position. I therefore accept you as my spiritual master, and I fall down under your lotus feet as your disciple. Sadhimang prapannam. I am surrendered. Now you kindly protect the surrendered soul. So here Krishna is instructing. First of all, he chastised Arjuna. Asachyananusuchastam prajñāvādān subhāsas. My dear Arjuna, you are talking like a very learned man, but I find that you do not know in which case you have to lament and in which case you have to joyful. That you do not know. Gatāsunāgatāsuṁśca nānu sochanti pandita. Indirectly he said that you are not pandita, you are a fool. Because you are arguing in this way, that if I kill my brother, their wives will be widow and they will become prostitute and there will be varna-saṅkāra. These questions are very nice. If women become prostitute, then the population is varna-saṅkāra. And varna-saṅkāra means unwanted children. They become practically nuisance in the society. Narakāya. If varna-saṅkāra population is increased, then the whole society becomes a hell. That's a fact. Actually, that is the position at the present moment. Therefore, according to the Vedic system, marriage is there. Without marriage, the population, increase of population means varnasam. So these things were discussed. But that was not the main case. The main case was whether Arjuna was to fight and to kill the other party. He was thinking very seriously. So Krishna in the beginning said that you are lamenting on the point that your brothers, your grandfather, they will die. That is the general impression of the people that I die, you die. But Bhagavad Gita says, na hannate hannamane sarire. Nobody dies even after the destruction of this body. This is the beginning of that instruction. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We are eternal. Nitya sasatayam. Na hannate hannamane sarire. Now where is the knowledge? We are traveling all over the world. We have never seen any university or any department of knowledge where this technique is instructed. Na hannate hannamane sarire. There is no such instruction. So just try to understand in the name of education how people are placed in ignorance. They are thinking that hannamane sarire hannate. After killing the body is finished. The man is finished. I was talking with a big professor in Moscow, Professor Katovsky. He said, Swamiji, after destruction of this body, there is nothing more. Everything is finished. So, just see, a big professor, a responsible person, he has no knowledge about this soul, what is body. He superficially, he is studying that after this body is finished, everything is finished. But that is not the fact. And persons who do not know this fact, they are becoming leaders, they are becoming educators, they are becoming spiritual master and so on. So how these people will be in knowledge? Because those who are teaching them, they are in ignorance. Andha-jathandai-rupaniyamana. One blind man is leading so many blind men. So where is the education? Here is the beginning of education, real education. What Krishna says, I have already explained that our process of accepting knowledge is the parampara system, avaraho pantha. There are two ways of acquiring knowledge, aroho pantha and avaraho pantha. Knowledge coming from the authorities, that is perfect knowledge. And knowledge acquired by experimental knowledge, that is not perfect. Because we are imperfect. Suppose a big professor, just like that, a Russian professor, Katovsky, they are trying to understand things by so-called inductive process or arhopantha, going up by one speculation, by speculative method. But our process of knowledge, Vedic process is knowledge, tad-vijñānārtham sa gurumeva abhigacchet. Their knowledge should be taken from the authority. Do not manufacture knowledge. Because how you can manufacture perfect knowledge? You are imperfect. Your senses are imperfect. You are defective in four ways. You are to err is human. You must commit mistake. You must be illusion. Your senses are imperfect and you have got a cheating propensity. These four defects are there. Those who are not liberated, muktapuros, they have got four defects. What is that? He must commit mistake. Just like we can give you instance, our Mahatma Gandhi, he was so great personality, but he also committed so many mistakes. Even on the day of his death, it is heard that he was forbidden not to go to the meeting. The other persons, they scented some danger, but he forcibly went there and he was killed. So, committing mistake to err is human, that is not fault, that is our habit, we commit mistake. And we are illusion. Illusion just like, I am not this body, I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. But we are giving identification with this body. I am Indian, I am American, I am Brahman, I am Sudra. So this is illusion. So to commit mistake and to become illusion and cheating propensity, actually I do not know things as they are. Still I am writing books to educate people. Big, big scholars. They have no clear thought, clear understanding. Still they write books. Even Darwin's theory, he is proposing, perhaps it may be, and he is writing a big book, Anthropology, and people have taken knowledge from that book. So if his knowledge based on perhaps, maybe, what is the value of that knowledge? So things are going on like that. The senses are imperfect. He has got a cheating propensity. Cheating propensity means he has no perfect knowledge. Still he wants to give knowledge, to become famous in the world, to famous in the community. So what is the value of your writing books if you have no perfect knowledge? But because you have got a cheating propensity, we do like that. So Vedic knowledge is not like that. There is no cheating. There is no imperfection. There is no illusion. There is no error. That is Vedic knowledge. So, the author of Vedic knowledge, who is the author of the Vedic knowledge? Not Lord Brahma. The author of Vedic knowledge is Krishna, as it is stated in the Srimad Bhagavata. Tene Brahma Rida Adikavai Mayanti Jasuraya. He imparted the knowledge, Brahma, Sabda Brahma, knowledge, into the heart of Lord Brahma. So Brahma is not self-sufficient. Actually, we are supposed to get knowledge, Vedic knowledge from Brahma, beginning from Brahma. But actually, it is not from Brahma. Brahma got the knowledge from Krishna. Tene Brahma. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Janmardasya Jataha. Annayat itaratascha teshu avijna sarat tene brahma rida adi kavai muhyanti jasuraya. So actually knowledge is coming from Krishna. So our proposal is we are receiving knowledge, this Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is directly giving you the knowledge. So we have to accept it as it is. We cannot interpret Bhagavad Gita in my own way. That is not Bhagavad Gita. That is something else. They take advantage of the Bhagavad Gita and put their own conclusion. That is not Bhagavad Gita. If you want to study Bhagavad Gita, then you have to study as it is. Then it is nice. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Aham adihi devanam, aham sarvasya prabhava, matta sarvam pravartate, mami vaja prapadyante, mayami dantarantite, nannat paratara. So these are the statements in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharmaan parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. If we do not accept Bhagavad Gita in terms of a statement given by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then it is useless. It is simply waste of time. You cannot make any commentary of your poor knowledge. There is nothing very difficult to understand in the Bhagavad Gita. It is written in very simple Sanskrit word, and things are very clear as the sunlight. Where is the question of showing the sunlight or the sun god with your lamp? Suppose now here is sunlight, sufficient light, you can see the sun and everything very clearly. If somebody brings some lamp and says, now I shall show you what is sun, it is useless. Bhagavad Gita is clear itself, just like the sunlight. It does not require any lamp bearer to show the Bhagavad Gita or Krishna. It does not require. You try to see Bhagavad Gita as it is, then you will be benefited. Otherwise, you will be misled. Just like in the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, dharma kshetri kurukshetri samavita yudhusava mamaka pandavasteva kima purvata sanja. It is very clear, dharma kshetri, kurukshetra is dharma kshetra. Still, there is kurukshetra, all of you know, and it is dharma kshetra, people go for pilgrimage, and in the Vedas also it is stated that kurukshetri dharma mahacharet, one should go to Kurukshetra and perform religious rituals there. So it is dharma kshetra by Vedic version, by practical example, dharma kshetri, Kurukshetra, but somebody is interpreting Kurukshetra as this body, from which dictionary he can get this meaning, that Kurukshetra means this body. This kind of interpretation is going on. But our proposition is that if you want to be benefited by reading Bhagavad Gita, don't read such malinterpretation. Read Bhagavad Gita as it is. Then you will be benefited. Kurukshetra, dharma kshetra, it is a fact. Kurukshetra is dharma kshetra. Samaveta yudhusava, and the persons assembled there, namely the Pandavas and the Kauravas, they wanted to fight Yudhusava, that's all right. Where is the interpretation? They wanted to fight, they selected a nice place, Dharma Khetra, Kurukshetra, and there they fought. So it is meaning is clear why there should be interpretation that the Pandava means the five senses and the Kurukshetra means his body. Why? Why? Where is the necessity of such interpretation? Interpretation is required where things are not clear. Actually, we do interpret. Just like in the law court, if some clause is not very clear, the lawyers interpret it may be like this, it may be like this. But when the things are clear, there is no question of interpretation. That is the system. Amongst the scholars, if things are clear, there should be no interpretation. The Bhagavad Gita, in each and every verse, the things are very, very clear as the sunshine. So there is no question of interpretation. However, this publication of Bhagavad Gita, we have therefore mentioned Bhagavad Gita as it is, because there are 640 different editions of Bhagavad Gita, and almost every one of them has got a different interpretation. That is the system going on now. Therefore, before me, many persons, many Swamis went to Western countries and they presented Bhagavad Gita in their own way, but not a single person became a devotee of Krishna throughout the whole history. Now Bhagavad Gita is being presented as it is, and thousands of them are becoming devotee of Krishna. Practically. Thousands of them. And the simple thing, I presented Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and they accepted it, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and by following the principles, within the 4 years, so many devotees of Krishna have come out, because there was no adulteration. So our request is, try to understand Bhagavad Gita without adulteration. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is presented. Then you will get knowledge. Otherwise, you will remain in the same ignorance before reading Bhagavad Gita and after reading Bhagavad Gita. This is our purpose. Here Krishna says, that dehinasmin jatha dehi, dehi deha. Deha means this body. And dehi means the owner of the body. there is the owner of the body. Now, modern scientists, modern philosophers, hardly they do know that there is a proprietor, owner of this body. This body is not the person. The person is within. Asmin Deh, within this body, there is the proprietor of the body. So, Asmin Deh, Dehin Asmin Jathadi. Now, Kumar Jovanangara, the changes that are taking place, it is not of the owner of the body, but it is of the outward, external body. Just like if you live in a house, the house becoming older, it does not mean you are becoming older. The owner of the house does not become deteriorated. It is a good example. Similarly, the changes, difference, the different types of body. The soul is migrating, transmigrating through different types of body. Jalajanamalakhani sthavara lakhavimshati. There are 8,400,000 forms of body. And the living entity is transmigrating from one body to another, one body to another, one body to another. This is the evolution. Darwin's evolution theory is misplaced. Here is real. As it is stated in the Padma Purana, asitim chaturang chaiva lakhang sthang jiva jatis. The evolutionary theory is there in the Padma Purana. Asitim chaturang chaiva lakhang sthang jiva jatis. Jiva jati. There are different forms of living entity. And they are 8,400,000. That is clearly stated. So one has to pass through from the beginning, Jalaja Navalakhani, 900,000 species of aquatics. So in this way, when we come to the human form of body, it is very rarely obtained. Manasam Dullavam Janma. It is very rarely obtained. Therefore, it should be very properly utilized in the human form of life. One should try to understand that he is not this body. He must know that I am Brahma, I am spirit soul, part and parcel of God. That is the beginning of teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Krishna said, Dehinasmin jathadehi, kaumaro jauvanang jada, tatha dehantaram prapti. As a soul, dehi is passing through different types of body, even in this life. First of all, he gets a small body within the womb of the mother, just like a pea. And that pea changes into another form, another form, another form. Then, when the form is complete, with hands and legs, it comes out. Then again, changes from babyhood to childhood, from childhood to boyhood, boyhood to youthhood. In this way, the living entity is changing the body. Not that the living entity itself is changing. It is changing simply body according to the necessity. That is explained here. Dehinasmin tatha dehi kaumaro jauvanang jara tatha dehantaram prapti. The point was to convince Arjuna that do not be believed because your grandfather will change the body. Your grandfather has got now old body, so he was giving the logic. Now if your grandfather is killed, why you are lamenting? He will get a fresh new body and a childhood body, then he will grow. You should rather become joyful that my old grandfather is going to have a new body of childhood, boyhood, youthhood. That was the argument. But the actual education is that we should not identify ourselves with this body. That is ignorance. Unless we understand that I am Brahma, I am spirit soul, there is no advancement of education. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita you will find, when one realizes that he is not this body, He is Brahma, spirit, soul. At that time, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, na sochati, na kankati. When one becomes Brahma Bhuta, self-realized, that I am not this body, at that time one becomes jubilant, Prasannatma. Actually, we are suffering being identified with this body. Matra sparshasya konti asitosna sukhadukkhala. All our trouble, actually it is so. The whole world is complete. But because we have identified with this body, we are thinking, we are American, we are Indian, we are Englishman, we are German, Russian, and we are demarcated. This is my country, this is my country, this is my country. Therefore, there is so much fight. For example, just like Pakistan, 20 years before there was no Pakistan. Now it is demarcated, this is Pakistan, and there is fight. So, if you want actually peace and prosperity in the world, then you must come to the Krishna consciousness movement. Otherwise, there is no possibility. Without coming to Krishna consciousness, now in the bodily consciousness, or national consciousness, or community consciousness, you cannot become happy at any time. You have to become Brahma Bhuta. That is Krishna consciousness. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. He will be happy, others will be happy. Without coming to that stage, you cannot be happy. So this Krishna consciousness movement is very important movement. We are trying to educate people to feel or to understand clearly that he is not this body, he is spirit soul. And at the present moment, all our activities are going on the bodily concept of life. That is called ignorance. Mura. Namang prabhadante mura. Duskitina naradhama. Krishna says, because one is under the bodily concept of life, his interest has become on the ground of this body. In other places also it is said, nate vidu sarthagatim hi Vishnu. Because they are under the bodily concept of life, they do not know what is their self-interest. One does not know actually what is his self-interest. His self-interest is to go back to home, back to God. That is his self-interest. But he does not know. Nate vidu sarthagatim hi Vishnu. Durasayadi bahirathamanya. He is trying to adjust things on the external bodily concept of life. And the so-called leaders are leading in that way. Andhadathan bhairupaniyamana stipisatantra urdhamnibaddha. They remain the same condition. The actual fact is that we are trying to be happy by political adjustment. But our mistaken point is that I am this body. Therefore the leaders are changing, but the improvement is not there. The same fight, the same antagonism, same barking like dogs and cats keep going on. Because everything is built up on the bodily concept of life. They're, not to speak of others, the first-class men of all nations, they assemble in the United Nations. In New York, we see generally, there was simply flag increasing. There are hundreds and thousands of flags, this nation, that nation, that nation. Where is unity? The unity means increasing flags, that's all. There was no Pakistani flag, now there is Pakistani flag, there is Sikhistani flag, this flag, that flag. But we cannot see that we are one. That can be possible only by advancement of Krishna consciousness, not on the bodily consciousness. Here you will find there are boys from America, from England, from Canada, from Africa, from Australia, but they are not thinking in terms of that he is Indian, American, Australian, this and that. They are thinking in terms of Krishna consciousness. Every one of us, we are thinking we are servant of Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.